We have seen this example from your textbook. Now, shall we enter into the exercise now? Exercise. The first question of the exercise is, fill in the blanks with if or unless. How you are going to fill in the blanks? You are going to make use of the word if or unless. Do you have your classwork notebook by side? Okay. So, why I asked you to have your classwork notebook? Instead of this word, if, how will you replace unless then? You have made a hint over there. If plus not can be changed as unless. Now, look at the statement, children. I won't be able to assist you if you give me all the details of the report. If you are going to supply if over here, the sentence looks meaningful. Read the sentence with me again. I won't be able to assist you if you give me all the details of the report. The sentence looks meaningful? No. So what should come there? Unless. I won't be able to assist you if you don't give me all the details of the report. If you, what will be the answer now? Unless. I won't be able to assist you unless you give me all the details of the report. If you are not going to give me all the details of the report, I won't be able to assist you. This is the meaning of the sentence. What is the meaning of the sentence? If you don't give me all the details, I won't be able to assist you. Instead of that, if and not, what we are supplying here? We are supplying here unless. Come to the next question now. I will take this job dash the working hours suit me. I will take this job. What will be the answer? The sentence is in positive form. Look at the sentence. Here you can see the sentence is in negative form. If here you can use won't and here you have to use not. See, here there is no not in the sentence. I'll take this job if the working hours suit me. If the working hour is going to suit me, I will take this job. The answer is right now. Are you writing down the answer? What is the answer for this? If. Come to the next question now. Dash he advertises on TV, he will get a lot of publicity. What kind of statement is this, children? I ask you to identify, no? What kind of statement is this? It is a positive kind of statement. How do you identify that this is a positive kind of statement? Because here there is no not in the sentence. You can see that there is no not in the sentence. Dash he advertises on TV, he will get a lot of publicity. Have an idea about it. Keep thinking. We will move on to the next sentence. Dash it is very cold. We will not have any snow. What kind of statement is this? This is a negative kind of statement. How do you know that this is a negative kind of statement? Because here we have a not in the statement. Are you clear? Next. Come to the next question now. The thief threatened to kill us. The thief threatened to kill us. Dash, we did not give him the money. What kind of statement it is? Is there any idea? We did not give him the money. The thief threatened to kill us. Dash, we did not give him money. Here there is a word not. So this is what statement? This is, you can see here it is. What kind of statement? This is a negative statement. And come to the last type of sentence. Last type of sentence. Dash you use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. Dash you use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. Again here there is a not in the sentence. What kind of statement it is? Negative kind of statement. Shall we give the answers from question C then? If he advertises on TV, he will get a lot of publicity, because this is a positive kind of statement. Come to the next statement then. What will be the answer? Dash, it is very cold. Dash, it is very cold. We will not have any snow. Unless it is very cold, we will not have any snow. And have a clear understanding in your mind why we are supplying here unless. If it is not very cold, you can write the sentence like this also. If it is not very cold, we will not have any snow. Instead of that, if and not, we are supplying unless over here. But shall we write if and not over here? If he not advertises on TV, he will get a lot of publicity. The sentence looks wrong. Come to the next question. The thief threatened to kill us if we did not give him money. The thief threatened to kill us if we did not give him money. So, here we are making use of the word if. Why we are making use of the word if? You may ask me a question, ma'am, why don't we use here unless? Because there is one more negative word here. What is the negative word here? Did not. If we use unless here, double negative should not come in a statement. Be clear, children. Double negative should not come in a statement. That is why we are making use of a positive word if. Because we already have a negative over here. What is that negative? Not. And here, there is no not. So, we are using unless. Are you clear with the statement now? Double negative should not be used. If you supply here unless, you will get double negatives. How you will get double negatives? This unless is already known as if plus not. And one more not you are going to have here. So, double negative should not be used. Come to the last statement. You use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. If you use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. The sentence looks wrong. So, what should come here? If you don't use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. So, if plus not, what will be the answer then? Unless you use high quality material, you cannot build a strong house. Are you clear with these things, children? Be very careful. A sentence should not be supported with double negatives. Shall we pass on to the next thing now? Next exercise? Okay. What we are going to do here? Join the following sentences using unless or if not. The sentence may require minor changes. One is done for you. Be careful with this wording, children. The sentence may require minor changes. One is done for you. Are you clear with this? Shall we start with the sentence now? What is the first sentence? I would never keep a large dog. I have time to exercise it properly. Listen to the statement carefully, children. Listen to the statement carefully. I would never keep a large dog. I have time to exercise it properly. What the person is trying to tell here? I will not have a large dog if I don't have time to exercise it properly. If I am not going to take my dog for a walk, if I am not going to bath it, if I am not going to spend time with it, I will not have a large dog for myself. This is the meaning of the statement. What is the answer now? How you can write the answer? I would never keep a large dog unless I have time to exercise it properly. See, here there is a word never. So, we have to supply the negative thing. What is the negative thing? Unless. Unless means it is understood if plus not. Unless means it is understood if plus not. So, for a negative type of sentences, we should use this negative word unless. For a positive type of sentences, we should use the positive word if, if, if. Are you clear with the sentence now? Shall we move on to the next statement? Okay, to start with the next statement, Sita would have come first in class. She had not fallen ill. Look at the sentence, children. Sita would have come first in class. She had not fallen ill. What will be the answer for this sentence? What is the meaning of the sentence? If Sita had not fallen ill, she would have come first in the class. That is the meaning, no? If I am good in my health, I will be able to attend my exams. If I am good in my health, I would have scored first rank in my class. What is the answer? Sita would have come first in class if she had not fallen ill. Okay. So, if she had not fallen ill. Why we are writing here if? Because there is a word not. She had not fallen ill. So, this if we are giving because there is already a word called not over here. Sita would have come first in class unless she had fallen ill. You can write the sentence also like this. How you can write? Sita would have come first in class unless she had fallen ill. Instead of this if and not, you can make use of unless here and you can write down the sentence. Are you clear with the thing now? Move to the next sentence now. What is the next sentence? You must not die. You have been properly trained. What is the condition? You should know to dive or you should be properly trained to dive. You must not dive. You have been properly trained. What will be the answer over here? It is a negative kind of statement. So, you have to use you must not dive unless you have been properly trained. Am I right with the sentence? Unless you have been properly trained, you can write the sentence this like also. Unless you have been properly trained, you must not dive. Unless you have been properly trained, you must not dive. Have you taken down the answer for this question? Come to the next question now. Medical evidence suggests that people would enjoy better health. They did not consume refined sugar. See here, the word not is already given in the other half of the sentence. What will be the answer then? Medical evidence suggests that people would enjoy better health. People would enjoy better health. One second, children. Let me make it clear for you. Medical evidence suggests that people would enjoy better health if they did not consume refined sugar. Or you can write the statement as medical evidence suggests that people would enjoy better health unless they consume refined sugar. Okay, they did not consume refined sugar. So, unless they consume refined sugar. Are you clear with the answer now? Medical evidence suggests that people would enjoy better health if they did not consume refined sugar. So, this is the statement. Are you clear with the statement? I have completed 4 questions for you. Will you be able to complete the other questions on your own? See to that whether the condition is positive or negative, then fill the statement. Will you fill the statement then? Okay, children. Thank you, children. Meet you in the next session. Bye-bye.